Hey, if you struggle with anxiety or attention issues, and if you find that you keep going back into the screen, I want to share some news with you about how neurofeedback can help you heal your brain so you feel less anxious, your attention improves, and you can heal from internet addictions. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. I'm a certified neurofeedback provider and a brain health coach. So in this video, I want to share with you new science on neurofeedback and how neurofeedback brain training can essentially heal the midbrain areas that have to do with dopamine. And from there, that healing in the midbrain has been shown in a recent research study to be able to extend to the cognitive thinking networks in your brain. And then with coaching, that has been shown to extend to improving your behaviors long term. I'm going to break that all down for you. So let's start with, first of all, what is neurofeedback brain training? So neurofeedback is based on something called operant conditioning. Basically, it's a learning modality. It doesn't put anything into your brain. Instead, what it does is it teaches your brain to make more medium speed for calm focus, the opposite of anxiety and attention challenges, that more of that medium speed in the middle so you can feel calm and focused. And what it does is it basically rewards your brain for making these medium speeds. If your brain goes back into the mode of anxiety or attention challenges, then there is no reward. There's not punishment, there's lack of reward, a non-reward. And what we know from science is that your brain will chase down the reward. So when it comes to internet addictions or anxiety or attention and a whole host of other brain-based challenges, we know that the reward center in the middle of the brain is acting in a dysregulated, dysfunctional manner. Dopamine is not being produced in a healthy way. When it comes to internet addictions and screen time, what happens is the more you go into the screen, the more your brain becomes flooded with dopamine at high levels. What that is shown to do is then when you're back in the real world in your life, your brain is in a dopamine deficit. This can lead to the anxiety, the stress, and the attention challenges that you struggle with. Dopamine in the screen, dopamine deficit outside of the screen. That's how all three of these A's are connected: anxiety, attention, and internet addictions. So what we know is that neurofeedback brain training can heal those dopamine centers in the midbrain, those reward centers. It's a new study that shows this. From there on out, there's many networks in your brain. One in particular is called the cognitive network. Basically, these are different areas of your brain that are working together so that you can think, you can focus, you can attend, you can have working memory and long-term memory. This cognitive network is also improved by neurofeedback therapy, not only midbrain, but other areas included in this network. That's how neurofeedback training can extend to other areas of your brain. And I'll tell you how it works specifically in just a second. But from there, what this scientific study shows is that it's imperative that you learn how to self-regulate and to emotionally regulate back in your life. This is a factor that was shown for ultimate success of neurofeedback in terms of having these brain changes carry over into your life. For many years, almost a decade, I have included coaching in my neurofeedback program because of this very reason. So a long time ago, I offered neurofeedback with no coaching. And then what I realized is the brain changes would show up, but a person doesn't know how to move through their specific individual human existence condition to be able to use that brain pattern. So now what we do is I'm able to use home neurofeedback, at-home technology. So at home, you can use the brain training headband with high top tier software that I can program it for exactly what your brain needs once I see what it needs on a QEEG brain map. It's visualized. I can see if your brain is running in the anxious mode. I can see if it needs improvement in attention. I can see if it's been flooded with dopamine from internet addictions. Then from there, we know exactly how the performance pattern in terms of using electrical energy needs to be shifted back towards the optimal green zone brain pattern. So from there, we use the technology. All you've got to do is get on the system and let the operant conditioning take hold, healing your brain from the inside out. That piece of brain rewiring does not necessitate you to think about it or to use your body in any specific manner. But if we want those benefits to carry over, we use the technology to rewire your brain, then we use coaching to hardwire those changes in. And it works like this. The way that it works is your brain is going to be in a new operating mode, but we need you to act and to think in a new mode. So if you struggle with attention and it's difficult for you to maintain attention for more than 15, 20 minutes, minute by minute, you extend that attention time frame. So if you're able to attend for 15 minutes, then you extend it by 16. You make it 16 minutes that you spend on your homework. Then you make it 19 minutes. Then you make it 21 minutes. And as neurofeedback is bringing your brain into the optimal zone, what you'll find is now you can attend for a lot longer. But you have to challenge your brain at that just perfect challenge towards your goal. That is the imperative piece when it comes to coaching. So what we know from neurofeedback is, yes, in fact, it changes the reward center in your brain, specifically how it's using dopamine. Number two, we know that that extends out to the cognitive networks that will help you think and feel and use attention skills better. Then from there, when you have coaching, you learn how to make these brain changes show up in your life so that now you're using them on a day-to-day basis. Essentially, that's how neurofeedback can help you for anxiety, ADHD, and internet addictions. If you'd like more information, please go over to drtrishleigh.com. And as always, control your brain or it'll control you.